subscribe Tag TV YouTube channel and press the notification button.
You're watching Tag TV.
India is well known around the world owing to its historical background, diverse cultures and interesting traditions. Its ancient scriptures and texts have been the way of life of its people for thousands of years. Today, the country is taking huge strides in the field of science and technology, paving a way towards a progressive India. So friends, I'm your host Shreya Savijay, and today in our episode of My India, we'll take a look at some of the stories that very well showcase the unique culture and prosperity of our country stretching from Himalayas to Kanyakumari. Eid al-Adha, the feast of sacrifice, is the most auspicious occasion for the Muslims. Celebrating Prophet Abraham's willingness to sacrifice everything for God, the festival falls on the 10th day of Dhu al-Hijjah, the 12th month in the Islamic calendar. Every year, it is celebrated with immense enthusiasm by the Muslims in India. But this year, amid coronavirus outbreak, the festival remained a low-key affair.
Wearing masks and adhering to social distancing norms, Muslims across the country congregated at mosques to observe Eid al-Adha. In the capital New Delhi, devotees decked up in new clothes thronged Jama Masjid, one of the largest mosques of the country. Though crowds were significantly thin as compared to previous years, but still thousands attended the prayers at the mosque, taking proper precautionary measures along with refraining from hugging each other after prayers.
Badi jagahon par jamghatta bheed bhaad kam hai kyunki corona infection bahut zyada hai. Social distance ke sath namaz hui, mask laga ke namaz hui aur puri tarah se jo niyam hai unko follow kiya gaya, to ye khushi ki baat hai. लेकिन बहुत शांति से नमाज हुई।
In the land of Nizams, Hyderabad, Muslims observe the festival in solitude. They prefer to stay at home and do their prayers rather than going to a mosque. Though the city never disappoints its residents when it comes to holding its celebrations with pomp, but this time the virus took away the sheen from the festival. Meanwhile, the mosque in the city of Nawab's Lucknow were also engulfed in silence. In one of the holy sites, only 5 people were seen praying at the designated mass praying spot.
आज ईद उल अजहा के मौके पर ईदगाह लखनऊ में सिर्फ और सिर्फ 5 लोगों ने नमाज अदा की है और जाहिर सी बात है जो COVID-19 का प्रोटोकॉल है और जो गवर्नमेंट की गाइडलाइंस हैं और जो इस्लामिक सेंटर ऑफ इंडिया की एडवाइजरी है और उलमा की अपीलें हैं उन तमाम बातों को मद्देनज़र रखते हुए ऐसा किया गया है.
In Kerala, Muslims observed Eid al-Adha after the moon was sighted in Middle Eastern countries. Though festival begins when the new crescent moon is sighted in Saudi Arabia, however, few Muslims prefer to celebrate the occasion as per the moon sightings in their homeland. Many mosques disallowed prayers owing to the rising coronavirus cases in the state, and only a few that were out of containment zones allowed limited entry of worshippers for prayers.
ഗവൺമെന്റിന്റെയും അതേപോലെ ആരോഗ്യ വകുപ്പിന്റെയും നിർദ്ദേശങ്ങൾ പാലിച്ചുകൊണ്ട് മാത്രമാണ് നമ്മൾ ഇന്ന് ഇവിടെ ബലിപെരുന്നാളിന്റെ നിസ്കാരവും ഖുതുബയും എല്ലാം നിർവഹിച്ചത്.
The festival of Eid al-Adha basically symbolizes our willingness to give up some of our own bounties in order to strengthen ties of friendship and help those who are in need. According to religious beliefs, the festival also coincides with the anniversary of the day when Quran was declared complete, and therefore many Muslims undertake Hajj, an important annual Islamic pilgrimage to the holy city of Mecca in Saudi Arabia.
Hinduism and Islam are both manifestations of the divine spirit. The call for the prayers is given in the mosque and the bell rings to the divine glory in the temples. These words of Chhatrapati Shivaji are best reflection of the bond that Hindus and Muslims have been sharing for ages. Recently, at the historic groundbreaking ceremony of Ram Temple in Ayodhya city of Uttar Pradesh, this bond got much more strengthened when prominent Muslims registered their presence at the event.
The holy city of Ayodhya became a melting point of myriad religions as it witnessed the historic groundbreaking ceremony of the magnificent temple of Lord Ram, a Hindu deity who is believed to be born in this city. The grand event, which was attended by dignitaries from all over the country, also witnessed the presence of a number of prominent Muslim personalities who have been living in Ayodhya for years. Iqbal Ansari, who was a litigant in Babri Mosque Ram birthplace case, was the first one to receive the invitation card in a gesture to promote amiable bond shared by the two communities.
तो अपने आप को ये समझते हैं कि ये भगवान राम की मर्जी रही कि पहला कार्ड इकबाल को दिया जाए. इकबाल को इकबाल अंसारी को पहला कार्ड मिला है, हमने उसको स्वीकार किया.
The celebrations of Ram Temple were not just limited to Ayodhya, but were perceived all across the subcontinent. In Aligarh city of Uttar Pradesh, locals were seen rejoicing the grand occasion with huge pomp and show. In one of the events, a Muslim clarinet player, Muhammad Yunus Khan, played a number of Ram dhuns, songs sung in praise of Lord Ram along with his team members as a tribute to the Hindu Lord Ram.
हमने राम जी की सेवा में और बजाई हैं और धार्मिक सारे प्रोग्राम बजाए हैं जी. हाँ, मैं मौके के खुशी के मौके पे हमें दक्षिणा भी मिली है, ऐसी बात नहीं.
With the foundation stone of Ram Temple being laid, weight of millions of Indians have finally come to the end. And to celebrate this happiness, they lighted huge rows and clusters of earthen lamps at their home and public places, marking the beginning of a new era of hope, unity and togetherness, the very essence of India's culture and foundation.
Now, a roundup of some of the major stories that made news recently.
A businessman in Surat city of Gujarat, Kader Sheikh, has converted his office into a COVID-19 facility for the treatment of the poor and needy free of cost. Around 30,000 square feet of office premises has been converted to a hospital. Sheikh decided to take this step after his brother contracted the deadly virus and he had to spend a lot of money for his treatment at the private clinic.
ये 84 बेड है, ऑलमोस्ट 100 बेड जैसे हो जाएंगे, पर 84 हाल में 84 बेड है, जिसमें 74 बेड जो है वो ऑक्सीजन वाले हैं और 10 जो है वेंटिलेटर वाले बेड है आईसीयू के साथ.
While Sheikh has brought the beds and will bear the cost of bed linens and electricity, the government will provide and pay for the staff, medical equipment and medicine.
Calligraphic artist in Jammu and Kashmir is holding on to the age-old tradition of calligraphy in a bid to revive the fading art. Saima Bhatt is a trainer of calligraphy in Srinagar who wants to promote it on a national scale.
एक्चुअली मैं चाहती हूँ कि हाँ ठीक है ये सारा कुछ है हमारे पास हम इस टाइम मतलब मॉडर्न टाइप इस टाइम चल रहा है सारा गैजेट्स का ज़माना है या फिर कंप्यूटर्स का ज़माना है सारा कुछ लेकिन हमें चाहिए कि हम जो हमारा पास्ट है जो हमारा कल्चर है जो हमारा अदब है हम उसको ना भूलें मैं चाहती हूँ कि ये प्रिजर्व रहे और जितना मुझसे हो सके अल्लाह का साथ रहा तो मैं इसको जितना हो सके मैं इसको प्रिजर्व करने की कोशिश करूँगी
Calligraphy, which is also known as Khatati in Persian and Khushnavisi in Urdu, is very much popular all over the world, especially in Islamic countries. In India too, this art form was quite prominent, but with advent in technology, it slowly started losing its sheen. But with efforts of artists like Saima, this art form is getting a new lease of life.
Non-profit organization in Maharashtra has started taking pre-recorded lessons to students in rural areas under its initiative Bolki Shala, which means spoken school. With no teacher physically present in front of them, children are taught via loudspeaker, which volunteers set up in various villages every morning. Once the setup is done, students sit a safe distance apart and wait for the spoken school to start.
आम्ही सगळा झाली का शाळेची वाट पाहतो ती 8 वाजेला स्पीकर येतो ते स्पीकर खुर्चीवर ठेवतात ते स्पीकर चालू करतात बोलतात त्याच्या मग आम्ही पण बोलतो गाणे सांगतो गोष्टी सांगतो कविता काय काय सांगतो इंग्लिश शब्द सांगतो ते स्पीकर आम्हाला खूप काय शिकवतो स्पीकर दादा स्पीकर ताई कोणी पण आहे तो जाम शिकवतो आम्हाला
This initiative of spoken school has been taken in the wake of pandemic due to which students have not been able to go to school for months. The NESN program covers 6 villages so far and aspires to reach around 1,000 students, especially those living in poor villages of Maharashtra where internet is not an option.
Teenage girls from Surat city of Gujarat have discovered an earthbound asteroid by poring through images from a University of Hawaii telescope. They discovered the object during an asteroid search campaign that was conducted by Space India, a private institute where both the girls Vaidehi Vikaria and Radhika Lakhani received training. The asteroid is presently near Mars and its orbit is expected to cross that of Earth in about 1 million years' time.
जो हमने ये क्षुद्र ग्रह खोजा है उसे ये नियर अर्थ ऑब्जेक्ट कहते हैं यानी कि वो पृथ्वी के नज़दीक में है यानी क्षुद्र ग्रह तो खोज लेते हैं सभी बच्चे ये खास इसलिए है क्योंकि ये जो हमारा मंगल ग्रह है उसकी कक्षा में घूम रहा है
Space India has said that the girls use a specialized software to analyze the images snapped by Pan-STARRS telescope in Hawaii and made the discovery in June The asteroid, currently called HLV-2514, will be officially christened only after NASA confirms its orbit.
India is well known across the world for its unity in diversity, and this variety is implicit to Indian festivals as well. In Kanpur, an extra hue got added to the festivity of Raksha Bandhan when people of two different faiths observed the occasion together. Through this act, they not only celebrated the beautiful bond between brothers and sisters, but also fostered the country's long-practiced communal harmony.
Four Over the last many years, a locality in the Kanpur city of Uttar Pradesh has been giving a new meaning to the Hindu festival of Raksha Bandhan. Every year on this occasion, both Hindu and Muslim people living here gather at one place and celebrate the occasion. While Muslim sisters tie Rakhi to Hindu brothers, the same is being followed by the Hindu women as well. And today, this tradition has become a medium to strengthen the bond between two communities.
हम लोग पिछले 10 वर्षों से इसी तरह रक्षाबंधन का त्यौहार मनाते हैं. हमारे हिंदू मुस्लिम जो भी हमारी बहनें हैं वो घर आती हैं, राखी बांधती हैं, और प्रत्येक वर्ष हम ये संकल्प लेते हैं कि जो भी बहन मुझे राखी बांधती है उसकी रक्षा करना हमारा धर्म और फर्ज है और उसका निर्वाह हमेशा करते हैं.
बहुत अच्छा लगता है राखी बांधना. ये हमारे बड़े भाई जैसे हैं और हम लोगों को इतना सम्मान देते हैं. बहुत अच्छा लगता है कि एक गैर मुस्लिम भाई हो के भी हमारा भाई जैसा फर्ज निभाते हैं. बहुत गर्व होता है.
In India, Raksha Bandhan is celebrated for ages and has many tales associated with it. One such tale which is symbolic to this beautiful brother-sister bond between Hindus and Muslims is that of Maharani Karnavati, the queen of Chittore and Emperor Humayun. It is said that when Chittore, the Rajput kingdom in Rajasthan, was threatened by Bahadur Shah of Mewar, the queen Karnavati sent Rakhi to Humayun, the Mughal emperor of Delhi. Humayun, who was aware of the significance of Rakhi in the Hindu community, willingly accepted it and promised to protect her. Today, the same tradition is being taken forward by a locality in Kanpur. And it is not just the Raksha Bandhan that is celebrated together by these Hindu and Muslim people, but other occasions too are observed with same enthusiasm.
तो ये हमारा सौभाग्य है कि मुस्लिम बहनें हमारी हम लोग को राखी बांधती हैं और हम लोग एक भाई की तरह उनकी रक्षा के लिए हमेशा खड़े रहते हैं. चाहे वो मुस्लिम का त्यौहार हो तो भी हम लोग एक परिवार की तरह शामिल होते हैं, चाहे हिंदुओं का त्यौहार हो उसमें भी हमारी मुस्लिम बहनें हमारे मुस्लिम भाई हम लोग एकदम परिवार की तरह हर त्यौहार बनाने का काम करते हैं.
रक्षा बंधन इज अ प्रोमिनेंट फेस्टिवल सेलिब्रेटेड ऑल अक्रॉस इंडिया. सिस्टर्स टाई सेक्रेट थ्रेड ऑन देयर ब्रदर्स रिस्ट एंड विश फॉर देयर वेलबींग एंड प्रॉस्पेरिटी, हु इन रिटर्न take a pledge for their security in every situation thrown at them.
Amid the coronavirus outbreak, creativity is touching new heights with artists across the country using their artists to create awareness about the virus. In Odisha, these creative minds have gone an extra mile in fighting the pandemic. From painting on the walls to designing miniature sculptures, they are using their creativity in every possible way to inform the locals about the deadly virus.
The walls of houses and pavements in the Kalahandi district of Odisha are shining with beautiful colors and paintings. All thanks to Pradeshi Sunani, a magnificent artist who has turned the place into a living museum. Though Sunani has painted a plethora of things, but presently he is busy using his art to create awareness in society about the coronavirus. From paintings depicting messages like staying at home, maintaining social distancing to giving a tribute to Corona warriors, the artist along with his team has painted a number of murals since the pandemic started.
यहाँ का जितने सारे आर्ट कल्चर है ये सब काम चल रहा है और सरकार की तरफ से हमारा जो कोरोना वायरस के ऊपर भी हमारा ये जन सचेतनता का काम कर रहे हैं. हम ये आर्ट कर रहे हैं.
Another artist is from the capital Bhubaneswar, who could be seen on the city streets dressed in a grey suit and a red cap urging people to stay inside their home and maintain social distancing. He uses mime, a theatrical performing art which involves storytelling without any use of speech to convey his message. Along with holding placards with messages scribbled on them, the artist also gives special demonstrations regarding washing hands and using sanitizers on a regular basis.
अभी जब कोरोना चल रहा है और मेरे पास जो माइम एक्टिंग का एक एक्सपीरियंस है, एक्सपर्टाइज है, उस एक्सपर्टाइज को मैं यूज करने के लिए सोचा। और ये जो रोग कोरोना है, ये बहुत बड़ी रोग नहीं है, उसको हम थोड़ी सी सचेतना से हम उसको निभा सकते हैं, मार सकते हैं, दूर कर सकते हैं।
L. S. Rao, a miniature artist and sculptor, is another creative mind from Bhubaneswar who has been using his unique pencil art to give the message of staying indoors. Rao has shaped the wooden part of the pencil and sculpted the words "Stay home, stay safe" on the graphite of it. This sculpture is 2.8 inches long and is created in a total span of 2 days. The artist also created a small house with total of 256 matchsticks, which he has placed in a glass bottle. This piece took 7 days to complete and depicts the same message.
मेरा यही निवेदन है, मैं जो लोग बिना कारण से जो बाहर घूमते हैं, उन सभी लोगों से मेरा यही रिक्वेस्ट है कि सब लोग घर में रहिए और सुरक्षित रहिए।
With lakhs of citizens in Odisha associated with paintings and artworks to earn their livelihood, the state successfully qualifies for being called as the land of artists and craftsmen. And presently, amid this outbreak, the artists in the state have been exploring their talent in the way to educate and aware the society.
That's all we have for you this week. Your comments and suggestions are important to us. Do give us your feedback at mindhere@anin.com. I'm your host Shreya Savijay, and it's goodbye from the entire production team.